Hello, and welcome to the HOME-ARP IDIS e-tutorials designed for Home Participating Jurisdictions, or PJs. This video tutorial will go over how to create and use Home American Rescue Plan, or HOME-ARP Subfunds and Subgrants. This video will define subfunds, also known as fund types, and subgrants, describe their use and purpose, show subfund and subgrant setup in IDIS, review common scenarios, and provide additional resources. A subfund is a way for the PJ to set aside funds for a specific purpose in IDIS. An example is the AD subfund, which allows the PJ to set aside funds for administrative and planning purposes. Subfunds are important because they help to enforce compliance with HOME-ARP spending limitations. For example, the AD subfund limits the PJ's spending on administration and planning to 15% of its HOME-ARP grant, as specified in the notice. A subgrant is a subset of a subfund. Subgrants are used to set aside funds within a subfund for a specific organization that will carry out a portion of the HOME-ARP award. All subgrants for a specific fund type should be set up under a single subfund. Before setting up or using subfunds or subgrants, it's important to know the different HOME-ARP fund types that are available in IDIS. EN, entitlement, is automatically set up in IDIS and is the portion of the HOME-ARP grant that is not otherwise subfunded. AD, administration, is also automatically set up in IDIS. AD funds are automatically capped at 15% of the total HOME-ARP grant. As a reminder, the AD subfund is initially limited to 5% of the HOME-ARP grant when the HOME-ARP grant agreement is first signed. This subfund will be authorized for up to 15% of the grant after the PJ's allocation plan is accepted by HUD and the grant is fully contracted. CO is for nonprofit operating expenses. This fund type is optional and is not automatically created by the system. When using optional fund types, the PJ must first set aside the funds by manually setting up a subfund. For optional subfund types, the PJ must create a subgrant to authorize funding for a specific organization. CO is capped at 5% of the HOME-ARP grant. These funds can be used to help support the regular ongoing operations of a nonprofit so they can better provide HOME-ARP services and activities. CB, Nonprofit Capacity Building Assistance, is also an optional subfund. If the PJ would like to use this fund type, the subfund must also be manually set up by the PJ. CB is a new fund type for HOME-ARP and is also capped at 5% of the HOME-ARP grant. Capacity Building Assistance is provided to nonprofit organizations to improve and expand the organization's ability to provide assistance. Capacity building expenses are defined as reasonable and necessary general operating costs that will result in expansion or improvement of an organization's ability to successfully carry out eligible HOME-ARP activities. SU, General Subgrant, is another optional fund type. The SU subfund is used to set aside funds for the HOME-ARP activities that are being carried out by the subrecipients or contractors. If the PJ would like to use this fund type, the subfund must also be manually set up by the PJ. It has no minimum or maximum amount. As a reminder, if using the optional subfunds CO, CB, and SU, they must be added manually in IDIS. To add a subfund, select Add from the left-hand subfund menu under the Grant tab. Then, on the Add Subfund screen, select Home for the program and 2021 for the program year. Click the search button. The search results will display all fund types available for the PJ to add, excluding those that have already been created for this grant. Be careful during this step. Home fund types will appear in these search results because there is no way to filter for just HOME-ARP fund types in the program drop-down menu. A blue ribbon appears next to the HOME-ARP grant number. The blue ribbon indicates that the grant is a HOME-ARP grant. When adding a HOME-ARP subfund, the PJ should click the Add Fund Type link next to the subfund type to be created. Under Authorized Amount for this subfund, enter the total amount of HOME-ARP funding that will be reserved for use under this subfund type. Click Save. The message Subfund Added should appear at the top of the screen if the subfund was successfully created. Next, optional subfund types require a subgrant to be created to authorize funding for a specific organization. A subfund may have one subgrant or several subgrants set up within it, but keep in mind that the PJ should have an executed written agreement with an organization prior to creating a subgrant for it in IDIS. To create a subgrant, go to the Grant tab at the top of the screen, then select Add from the left-hand subgrant menu under the Grant tab. Under Program, select Home, and to the right of Grant Number, select the HOME-ARP grant number from the drop-down menu. A small star will be displayed next to the HOME-ARP grant number. To create the subgrant, the PJ must select the fund type that it used previously to set up the subfund in IDIS. Then choose Select Organization to go to the Subgrant Recipient page. The PJ has two options. It can search for an organization that has previously been entered into IDIS or add a new organization. To locate an existing recipient in IDIS, on the Select Recipient page, use the search criteria to locate the appropriate subgrant recipient organization. Use the nonprofit search criteria to narrow the search results. Click Search and select the intended organization. If the organization does not appear, try selecting Reset to reduce the number of search criteria. If this organization is not in IDIS, the PJ must first enter the organization in IDIS by selecting Add Organization at the top of the Select Recipient page. The new recipient organization can then be selected. Finally, enter the amount for the HOME-ARP subgrant for this recipient organization. This amount must match the amount specified in the written agreement with the recipient organization. And click Save. This section will consider several common scenarios the PJ may encounter when setting up and using HOME-ARP subfunds and subgrants. In Scenario 1, a state PJ has executed a state recipient agreement for $300,000 of its HOME-ARP allocation with a nonprofit organization to administer the TBRA program. In this situation, does the PJ need to create a subfund and a subgrant? Yes, the PJ needs to create a subfund and a subgrant for the nonprofit organization that will administer the TBRA program. Which subfund and subgrant type should be used to fund the activity? In this situation, the PJ needs to set up an SU subgrant. Remember, the SU fund type must be used to fund any HOME-ARP activities that are being carried out by subrecipients or contractors. The PJ must first manually create an SU subfund for the HOME-ARP grant, then add an SU subgrant for the nonprofit organization under that subfund. The subrecipient-administered TBRA activity will then be funded with this SU subgrant. In the next scenario, the PJ has budgeted $1 million for the development of non-congregate shelters. It issued an RFP and selected two projects to be developed. Should the PJ set up a subgrant for each of the project developers? No, the PJ wouldn't set up a subgrant for the project developers of the non-congregate shelters. The PJ does not have any executed subrecipient agreements, so it should not be setting up any subgrants. In addition, the developers are not administering part of the PJ's HOME-ARP program and therefore are not considered subrecipients. They do not require the use of an SU subgrant in IDIS. Which fund type should the PJ use to fund the activity? The PJ would use the EN fund type to fund this activity. For more information on HOME-ARP subfunds and subgrants, see the HOME-ARP fact sheets. IDIS for nonprofit operating and nonprofit capacity building activities. IDIS for tenant-based rental assistance activities. And IDIS for supportive services activities. For more help with IDIS, see the HOME-ARP FAQs on HUD.gov or send your questions to the IDIS Ask a Question Help Desk on HUDExchange and Chapters 16 and 17 of the Home IDIS Training Manual for PJs. Questions about HOME-ARP can also be sent to HOME-ARP at hud.gov.